Hey guys, today I'm gonna talk about some performance hacks to make the most out of your OnePlus Pad, and I am stoked to get my hands on this bad boy. We're getting into some performance tips and tricks, but if you're wanting to learn more about what it's like drawing with the pad, check out the video where my buddy Rico talks about how easy it is to use the stylo. All right, let's dive in. With any of my new devices, I like to mess around with them first to see what I like and what I don't like with the factory settings. And after spending quite a bit of time with the pad, here are my top 8 tips to make this pad shine. The OnePlus Pad comes with an impressive screen that it refreshes at 144 hertz, displaying 144 frames per second. That's what gives it its smooth, buttery performance, but the factory settings are set to refresh at 60 hertz. I'm going to change that. So, I'm going to go into settings, display and brightness, scroll down into screen refresh rate. Then tap it and choose high. That's it. I mean, I will note that the refresh rates will dynamically change based on whether an app supports 144 hertz. Everything else will adjust to whatever support levels are needed. I make a lot of video calls throughout the day, and not only does the OnePlus Pad have a camera in the right spot, the middle, but it also has a great feature called Limelight. This basically ensures that your face is always front and center. So to enable this, once again, you need to go to settings, click on special features, then click on Limelight. Limelight. From here, you can see one of your preferred video called apps, and all you have to do is toggle a little tiny button next to that, and that will turn it on. That's it. You can be the star of all your own video calls, and you'll never have to miss your face going off screen again. Okay, let's be real. Passcodes are annoying. I hate them. I hate passwords. So to avoid inevitable wrong passcode entered warnings, you just have to register your face to unlock the pad. So I'm going to go to settings, passwords and security. Click on face, enroll, and from there you're gonna follow the prompts, and that's it. You are all set to unlock your phone with just your face. No hands required. Well, just to set it up, but your face is the real star here. The pad has a powerful MediaTek Dimensity 9000 processor, but the current default settings don't make the most of that power in order to preserve battery life. But I'm a greedy little goblin and I want all the power. So I am going to set high performance mode. This is how you do that. You're going to go to settings, battery, weird.
I know that, right?
Battery. And then you tap more settings, also weird. But fine. And here you can activate high performance mode. So you'll get all the warnings that will use more power, but with great power comes great responsibility. And by great responsibility, I mean absolutely awesome performance. The stylo is an extra accessory, but it is absolutely worth getting. If you have one with your pad, you'll want to customize the double tap function to your preference. So, going to go to settings, click on additional settings, then click on stylus and double tap stylus. From there, you can choose from switch between current tool and eraser, switch between current tool and last used, show color palette, or just turn it off altogether. Now, I'm not an illustrator, so I'm going to set this to switch between current tool and last used, so that I can go back to previous apps. And that is it. The pad keyboard is also pretty great. So this is an extra accessory you can add. And honestly, if you do plan on using this to work and work from, I recommend getting it. Because the best part of this is that there is a keyboard shortcut you can check out. You just go to settings, click on additional settings, then click on keyboard and input method, OnePlus magnetic keyboard, and lastly, shortcuts. Then you can see a menu pop up with a list of all the useful shortcuts like lock screen or screenshots or shortcuts to open whatever kind of app you'd like. I just want to take a moment to show some love to this 7:5 aspect ratio display. There is no better screen to have apps in use side by side than on this pad. So if you haven't set it up, when you first open up your pad, make sure to go to settings, then click on special features, then split screen. From there, you can select the two-finger swipe down motion to split the screen. So when you're just using one app, you just swipe down like so, and that'll split the screen. Then you can select the other app you want displayed side by side with the one that you just had up. That is a thing of beauty. My goodness. And last but not least, float mode. So if split screen wasn't cool enough for you, OnePlus One upped it. Get it? Yeah, with float mode. So this doesn't require diving into your settings, you just need to do a zoom out gesture with four fingers on the pad. And the app should then transform into a floating window. Now from there, you can move the app around, you can resize it, and even drag files from one app into the other. Now this is really going to amp up your performance game. All right, y'all, thanks so much for joining. I hope that this helps make your experience with the OnePlus Pad even better. Be sure to like and subscribe for all the latest videos on our channel. Later.